Now what we're going to be doing is we are going to take our Q-tips and we're going to go through and we're just going to clean this out. And use up a lot of Q-tips. You don't want to be thrifty with these. You just want to keep on switching them out. They get dirty. I mean, you can see that one got really dirty really quick. You just want to wipe this till pretty much the Q-tips looking really, really clean. Once that's cleaned up, I like putting a little oil, okay? Some people say don't do this, but I like doing it and this helps kind of clean a little more. So take your oil. You don't want to soak it too much, but that'll help kind of pick up even more on your Q-tips. Okay, now take your dry end, wipe that excess oil off. Some people say that'll make it stick, the grime stick more and whatnot. I've never had that issue. I like doing it this way. It really cleans it up and oils it. I mean, it keeps everything moving nice. These little gears, usually I take them out, but for some reason this is not popping up right now. So you just want to go through each one. If you notice, some of these screws were having some trouble getting out. I was, at least. And that's where the soapy water comes in. Take your Dawn soapy water. And you remember these two screws, I'm going to put those in next. We're going to actually fit everything back together here. So those screws were these two right here. Okay. Now I'm going to actually take those and I'm going to dip them in the soapy water, run them through my fingers quite a bit. Might not have been able to see that, but I ran them through my fingers and then just dry them off. Set those aside. I'm going to do that same thing with this other one. Now, this is where the grease comes in. Just put a little dot of grease. And I like doing that with a really fine, teeny tiny little screwdriver. That's how I do it. So I take a fine little screwdriver, because a squeeze bottle, okay? You've got a little dot of that, and literally all you need is one dot, okay? Do that with the other one. Just right on the end. And when you're screwing it on, it'll kind of work its way through. You want to give it a nice little, you know, you want to make it tight. You don't want to go crazy, though. I mean, you don't want this to be super tight. You don't need it. What really helps is magnetic screwdrivers here. But how we fix that, every once in a while, a little dab of oil, or not oil, of grease, and then the screwdriver, and it will hold it. Okay. Those two are back on. Okay. Let's go ahead and take another dab of the grease. And we are going to put a little bit, not a lot, just a little bit. Just a couple spots along this gear here. Okay, and that's all you need. You don't need a lot. And you don't need to put it all the way around, just a couple. And then just spin it, and it'll actually get it in there. Okay? And that'll keep that moving free. Next thing, we want to put this in, or actually, we actually want to clean this off. So this is the next step. Put this back together, is this spool bearing. And let's clean the inside of it here too, where the spool's actually going in with a Q-tip, okay? And then you stick that right back in. And now we are gonna degrease this, put it in your solution, work it through your fingers, get all that grease off. This is that plastic piece. Now this is very, very tricky because we want to clean that, we want to clean this. These all go together. They're kind of tough to get on. I always had trouble with these. You see that little hole there? This fits right in that hole. And you've got a tiny little hole right there. I don't know if you can see that. Right on the end of that, right there. Okay. And now you've got that hole. See on the end of that? And there's a post right there. Once you stick, these are the two components. Okay, you stick that post, or you stick that through the post, okay? And then, tricky part is getting that lined up in there, all right? So now, once that's on the post, now that plastic piece will fit in there like that, and that's where well, I'm afraid of that popping out. So, but you can see where it fits, all right? Now that that's on there, and that's pretty good, that's not gonna pop out now. We're gonna degrease our little release post here. And the two screws that go with it. Dot of that grease, help keep that moving back and forth over the years. Just right on the end, and that'll kind of work its way through the threading. Alright. So, see these little notches in there? Those notches, you can see the holes right there. Those will fit. Over the holes just like so. Loosely, you don't want that super tight, okay? In fact, I made that too tight. Bring that out. Loosely put the first one so you can get the second one in there easy. Now, as they will thread that on there, you can see the two screws sticking out right next to those posts. Now we can tighten that in there nice and tight. All right, so now that's in there, I'm not worried about this all popping out. You can see how that system works. Okay? We've got that, though, because the system moves, okay, we're gonna wanna put a little grease in there. So I'm actually gonna pull those screws out. Forgot to do that. Like I said, it's been a while. I'm not gonna fully take them out. They're a pain in the butt to get back in. Just light enough that I can pull this little, see how it wiggles? And I can actually wipe a tiny bit of this grease right under there. You don't want a lot. Just enough. Keep this whole system moving. I'm gonna do it a couple areas throughout. Now we're going to screw those screws right back on tight. And what you'd really want to do, probably the best way, would be put it on the bottom of this silvery metal thing. And a lot of the systems are the same in that way. So, yeah, see that moves a lot easier. That's much better. Okay, but you want to wipe off the excess. Make sure there's no excess grease. So now, oops, we're gonna want to degrease these components now, because those go on top. Again, like I said before, you're going to make sure you remember which way goes up, okay? But if you mess up, how you know is, if you forget, see how this, there's a ramp that goes up here? See that ramp? And this has a ramp, I don't know if you can see. Well, that has a ramp that goes down. And at least with these Shimanos, that's how that works. And that ramp, you want to put against that. So what happens is, as you, you can see, that pushes that up. And that's what detaches the spool. And this has a lot of grease on it. You want to clean that off. And this also has gears, so you're really going to want to take a toothbrush to it. After you put it in the soapy water, make sure there's no soap through there. That's where the spool shaft is going to go, or the whatever you would call it. That part goes right through there. Make sure there's no water in there. Then take your toothbrush, get all those gears. Okay, wipe it off again, make sure that's really clean, and then I take, you still want some oil, because you need this to freely spin when you're, and that is going to fit, and in fact, you need to take this off, forgot about that, this part is going to fit right in that smooth section right in between there. So I just put a little, just a little, you don't need a lot, okay? You don't have to go all the way around, okay? And this sits down like that, and that goes right in like that. Now you can put that right in like that. And you've got these little springs, those go on top of those little posts. You see there's one on this side, and then goes on that side. That both of those go on like that. Okay? Now we're going to work on the gears. I'm going to set this whole thing aside for now. I'm going to clean each one of these. Okay, just this top plate. Make sure you remember the order they go in if you haven't done it before. Okay, I'm not too worried because I know exactly where they go. Okay, now these are fragile. Okay, so be careful. You still want to get as much of the grease off, the dirty grease as possible. So what I do is I set it on a flat surface and I do this, okay? You don't want to bend it. If you bend it, if you bend it like this, you're going to break it. Okay, and this, wow, this was really dry. I actually sometimes will go like this and just kind of, boy, that was a really dry drag. I hadn't taken this apart in a while. That really needs to be oiled. So there's some different schools of thought on this. The drier the drag, the more drag you're going to get, but it's also not going to be as smooth. Put a little oil on there, it's going to actually, or a little grease, it's going to actually smooth it out quite a bit, but you're not going to have as much pressure. I tend to, I mean, you know, these reels go at, I think, 10 pounds a drag, maybe 12, depending on the one, but usually that's about the going rate right now for them. Some of them are a little higher, up to 20, some are a little lighter for these little bait casters. And that's enough. I mean, really, for most fishing that you're doing, that's enough. You're not throwing, you know, 20-pound test, you put 10 pounds of drag on 20 pounds of test, it might snap the line. And the reason why is because you've not only got pressure from the drag alone, you've got a friction going from each guide of your reel, of your rod. Have you ever noticed, like, when you're fishing, you pull back real hard on the rod and it keeps the fish from going out. They can't pull as much line because you're adding angles to it and it's adding more friction. Once you bend the rod down straight, you're going to have them take off a little better. They're going to pull line out. That's how you fight a fish. I'm sure you know that. So, I tend to like adding a little grease on this. I like having, quite a bit actually. I like it very smooth drag because to me, I can always just lift up heavy on the rod. If I really need, I can thumb the reel a little bit. That's just how I fish. But I like having that really ridiculously smooth drag whenever possible, okay? Because I don't want to lose a fish off of a, too much pressure is bad. So, all right, so this, it's actually, you can see it's starting to get a little corroded. Most of these do. That's always going to happen, but it's not an old reel, so really want to make sure I've got this nice and cleaned up. So I've got the soapy water on there. Okay, I'm actually, with the soapy water, I'm going to really get through these gears here with the toothbrush. Really get all that dirty grease off of it. Okay. Dry it off the best possible, as best as you can. Okay, I'm gonna actually dry off my toothbrush here. By the way, you can use like a gun brush, that would even work better. Not the metal ones though, you don't want to scratch this. You want to use the plastic ones. Those will work really well, but toothbrushes are just fine. Whatever you got. Generally, if you're like me, most fishermen are, they also hunt, a lot of them. They do both, so I'm sure you've got gun cleaning stuff at your house, so that's all you got, it'll work. Now I'm going to take a fresh Q-tip here, and I'm going to work all the grease out of the center part here, okay? Just as tight as you can, you can see that's getting pretty dirty, okay? Through the center here, you just want every bit of grease off this. You want this as smooth as possible. Every bit of grease. Okay, around here. Okay, that's pretty well cleaned. You can see how dirty that is. You want to make that as clean as possible. So again, the Dawn is a good degreaser. And it's just a solvent, so, you definitely don't want to leave it on there, but I find Dawn and water, soapy water here like this, works great for degreasing. Alright. Now we've got that nice and clean. And we've got another washer. Now, this one is starting to... I might need to replace it soon, but you can see how that's starting to be flat on parts. You can see the... on this one here. It's kind of... might be hard to see, but you see, like, you've got the, like, kind of... pattern here. It's got bumps, it's got, you've got the weaves of the material, right? But this one, there's spots that are flat. You can see that naturally getting a little smooth and shiny. That means I'm losing on that side there. You can see it's a little rougher on that side, but the smoother it is, like I was saying before, the more the smoother the drag is, but the less pressure you're going to have. So, let's try to get all the grease off. Wow, that's really kind of greasy, you can see. But again, don't bust these. Do not break them. I've done it before. Too much pressure. You don't want to do. See if we can get a lot of that grease off. It might just be compacted grease. See if we can rough that up more and get us a little bit more drag. So again, we've got two drag washers. That's really what goes on here, okay? This is Shimano, okay? Some other reels have three, some have two. Really depends, okay? On the bait caster. Some have one. I think a couple of the older Abu Garcias have just one. Alright, so that roughed up quite a bit more, actually.
See, so still some smooth spots. I don't know if you can see that. It's kind of not focusing. Hey, focus. Here we go. It's a little rougher, but there are still some smooth spots. I couldn't get it all out. All right. So this is going to go down first. Okay. You've got that washer. Okay. And you've got a square spot at the bottom of the shaft. It's just going to go down at the bottom of the shaft, and you're going to rotate it till it pops right in. Okay. Then you've got this washer. But before we do that, before we put that washer on, up to you. If you want to put it on dry, some people do it. They get more, you know, it's not going to be as smooth, but you do get more pressure. So I'm going to put a little grease on my fingers, and I'm just going to lightly coat this washer, okay? You really don't want a lot, okay? Again, the more grease you have, smoother the reel, but you put too much, it's going to just be too slippery. Okay, and you want to get all the excess off. You don't want any excess. So I've got a light coat on that washer. Boom. And now this one goes down. And it goes down. There's kind of like a recess here. That goes up. Okay? And then the flat part goes down. And before we do that, before we put that on, I'm going to grab a little grease on my finger. You don't want a lot. See, just a dab. I'm going to run that along the gears like that. Now I'm going to wipe it off. Wipe off the top, wipe off the bottom just enough. Keep those gears moving, okay? Oh, not doing that in camera. So, you can see you've got just a light amount. And it's not all the way around. It's only on one spot. See, it's not there. And just a little bit. You don't want a lot. You grease it up too much, then you're gonna have more trouble than it's worth. Might be smooth, but see, these gears, they move around these other gears. Okay, so you've got the spool release right there. All right, and there's a gear. You can see the gear right there. So when this spins, you're spinning the spool. That's how that works. Now, when you press down for the spool release, when you're ready to cast, this will pop up and get it out of the gear of this. So it'll actually detach from that. That's how these work. That's basically what happens. But when you're spinning this as you go, that little bit of grease in there, that's all you need. You don't need a lot. You need a lot of grease because that will work its way through these gears, okay, and just cover the whole area. And again, we're not talking a lot. We don't need a lot. We don't want a lot. All right, so the next one is going to be this drag washer. Again, I like to add a little grease, up to you. Just depends on, I guess, what you're fishing. I guess if you're going to fish like a small little reel like this for, you know, big pike or something, and you really need a lot of pressure, and you're using like 40 pound test, I guess you don't want any grease. You need a lot less. But generally, you know, I use these for bass fishing, inshore fishing, for, you know, these little bait casters inshore for, you know, like reds and stuff, and we're talking 20 pound test at most. A lot of times I'm fishing 15. I don't need more than 10 pounds of, you know, I mean, heck, 10 is enough. I think probably 5 would be enough, really, of drag pressure to hold those fish the way I need. All right. So now we stuck that right in the recess, and that's why there's a recess like that, right, in there. So we stuck that right in after coating it with a little bit of grease. Now you've got weird like shape like that, and that's the same shape as your shaft here. And you just put it on that over top. You don't need to put any grease on it. You don't need to do anything. That sits right on top. What happens is you're pushing, when you're tightening that drag, you're pushing down on those, which ends up spinning those drag washers, or spinning this around the drag washers. This stays put, and those drag washers will move and allows this to spin without the shaft spinning. So you're sitting there like this, and it allows this to go. You can see that spinning, even though this is top part isn't moving. Okay, the more pressure you put on that, the harder it is. See, I can't even move it. if you put pressure because you've got the drag washers. Okay? So it's all about friction, basically. All right. So now we've got all the inside components together, I believe. Make sure. Yep. So now I'm going to clean out this side plate. You can see you've got a lot of grease in there. I'd like to get all that out. So I'm going to use an old, dirty one, so I'm not, you know, for these big goops of oil. Okay. So I'm not wasting a whole bunch of, it's, you know, you can waste it, whatever, if you want to use new ones. I'm kind of thrifty with everything I do. Okay, and you don't want to get any oil or any grease at all on this bearing, okay? None whatsoever. If you do, buy a new bearing. Buy it from Shimano. And actually, you know what's really interesting, you can actually, like, you don't have to get it from Shimano. I think there's a company called Boca Bearings I've used before. You can buy a bearing from them. They sell them. Pretty decent deals. You can actually upgrade these bearings to, like, ceramic bearings. Basically, you just... I don't know how you get this one out, though. I'm going to tell you. I'm kind of confused. I have that trouble. I'll have to look it up. There might be something new with these, the way that they put them together. So now I've got new ones here. I'm just going to go through and clean out. You know, you're just getting every single nook and cranny. Try to get all the... You know, any of the dirt that's in there, in this grease that's old, dirt, salt, whatever, will actually corrode rather than help. So you really want to get it all out. Pretty much do this until you're coming up with very clean looking Q-tips. Okay. Then, personally, up to you. Again, I'm going to add a little bit of oil. We're talking very little. It's not soaking the inside of it, okay? It's just enough to then pick up the last little bit of grime. That's what I like doing. I mean, you don't have to. You really don't. See if I can do it where you can see what I'm doing here. And see, I'm going around. I'm not touching the bearing. I don't want to get anywhere near it. You don't want any oil, no nothing in there. And I take that back. There's sometimes you want to add a little oil on that bearing. Every once in a while, but generally no. That's only if you, like, drop this in salt water or something. Just to, you know. And then I'm going to take a dry one more. I'm going to wipe down just to get any excess oil that I used to just now to clean it. Okay. So, there we go. It's nice and clean. Now we've got all the grease that we need on there. We don't need any more on here. We need nothing. This can stay dry. We've got all the grease we need in the reel. Again, very light. We don't need a lot of grease. The more grease, sure, maybe the reel might get smoother, but also is going to get mucked up a lot more. I generally like to keep these very, very grease-free in a way. Okay. With a very clean one now, I like to go through, I want to go through and clean out this bearing. Oh, wait. That bearing is popping out. Heck. Well, look at that. There was this little spacer that kept it from coming out. So I'm going to take a dry Q-tip. I'm going to rinse that out, wash that out. Dry paper towel. Just work that bearing in my fingers. It goes back in. Alright, so there's little ridges on this little piece. On one side, those ridges I think go down, not up. Yeah. And that'll help keep that in there. It kind of locks it in. So I'm going to push that piece in without touching the bearing. I'm going to drop that bearing right in the back here. I believe. No. Let's take that out. Again, first time I've opened up this reel. I should have probably looked at the manual. Alright, so that bearing drops in from the top.
And then the bushing spacer here, a plastic, white plastic spacer goes on top to lock that in. There you go. Yep. Those little things, screws go down, and that's what you can actually hear it click when you push it down. It'll click. All right. There we go. Then we got another bearing. And that we're going to clean off the same way by just working it in your fingers with a dry paper towel, not a wet one. And this has a very small space in between, but I like cleaning those out. And I'll show you how to do that in a second. Just make sure this is really, really dry, or really wiped off. You don't want any grease on these at all. And pop that in. Take a fresh Q-tip to push that down. So that way you're not adding any grease. Now, you can take one of these, maybe not a wet one, but pull off some of the stuff. There we go. Some of the cotton on your Q-tip, and that will actually fit right through there, like that. That's the way you get inside, okay, to clean out that. And look, I've got a little dirt. It's hard to see, but I do have a little dirt on there. And that'll keep everything clean. Now, we've got the next part. Our next part is going to be, clean that section out. All right, I want to make sure that the hole in there, okay, we're going to just with a dry, move these, let me get another paper towel. Dry paper towel. All we're going to do is take this. Again, you want to make sure you know which side is up. Okay, and you just want to wipe it down, then take a dry Q-tip. Go in between and just do this. Just twist it around. Wow, you can see how dirty that is. Just keep doing that until that comes out dry, or it comes out, clean. Yep. That's still a little dirty. I'm gonna grab one more new one. Still a little dirty. You just want to clean that out as best as possible. All right, same thing with this. You just want to clean this out, clean this up best you can. Dry it off, okay? Get all the grease. I do not put this one in water, in the soapy water. You just don't need to. It can cause more harm than good. Take a dry, a fresh Q-tip, clean out the center. Okay, that came out a little dirty. Let's just switch it to the other side. And that came out clean. So there we go. So next, we don't want a lot, okay? This is very, very little. But we're gonna stick this on the shaft. We don't need any grease on the inside part. Any oil, I mean, but we want just a dot. Just a little bit, okay? We don't need a lot. Look, it's just very little, okay? And then just wipe it around with your finger, okay? Like that. Very little, that's all we need. Drop that right on top. You can see there's little, those little nubs, and they go right in those little holes, like that, boom. Okay? Next, we're gonna take the anti-reverse, we're gonna put it in the right direction. Now I'll show you a trick. I think I'm putting this in the other direction. So it's gonna, you know, it's not gonna reel on me, okay? So then you put this on top of everything until that clicks down. You wanna make sure all the seams around are good, and you wanna hold it with your fingers like this. Then you can test and see, I'm turning it, and I'm not able to turn this reel. I can only turn it backwards. So I'm actually going the wrong direction with it. Anti-reverse is not working, okay? So how you fix that, you take that off, pop out that little shaft here, Don't need to add any other oil again because it's already on there. And you're going to pop this out like that. You're going to turn it around and put it in the other direction. And now you can test that. And now it's, see, I'm turning it and then it's not going backwards. There you go. The anti-reverse bearing is working. I'm going to do a quick little, probably should have done that before I put that on, but that's all right. Those gears, always want to use a toothbrush with gears. And a little dirt, not bad. So now we're going to put together the rest of the components here. Let's do that later. Let's do those last. We're going to put on these. So these two, remember those two, you want them opposite like this, so they're bent away from each other, okay? Put the first one on. We've got a little curve to them. It's going to be hard to see maybe in the camera, but it does have a curve upward. You want to put the curve on this one downward, okay? You don't need any grease, nothing on those, okay? And then I always put this copper, there's a copper side and a silver side. Okay, put the silver side down. Okay. And then this, there's a groove. You see that groove? That goes up. Okay, that's where the spring rests in. Okay. And before we do that, I'm going to add, I've got my grease here. I'm going to add a little bit. See, just a little around the top part. That's actually going to sit here, not on the top part, but might as well grease the top part too while we're at it. Just a little bit. I'm not putting a lot. Only on one side. You don't need it on both. I'm just going to take my finger and wipe. Sorry, take my finger and just wipe that off. The excess. Now we've got. And you only need to do it on one side because, look, this is spinning around it, and it's going to pull up that grease, and it's going to put it on the other side, too. All right, so then this is going to just start spinning, right, once it hits any kind of pressure there. So you need to grab this part. There we go. And then you can spin backwards. There we go. You don't need it super tight. And before we do anything else, I'm going to make sure, and let's go with these screws, okay, to make sure the side plate stays on so I'm not having to hold it. Probably should have done that before I started with the components. All right, so I'm degreasing water, the Dawn solution. Boom. Let's take a little more grease. Again, we're going to put a little dot on the end. Don't need a lot. Okay. That one goes right there. Now, some of these older Shimano's, I think these are all the same size, but some of the older ones have different size screws. So you, again, got to make sure you lay things out where you're going to remember. There we go. Same thing. Now, that's on there. Okay. You want to be careful. You don't want to go crazy with this. Okay, but now that's holding that in. So now you got two hands. You can mess with the screws. Okay, so degrease. Now for the final. This one's really grimy. So just because it's on the inside there, the spool like that, when the spool's spinning, you're getting a lot of dirt and grime, that more so than you are on the outside. So this one's kind of grimy, this one's kind of dirty. Everything seems to be working good, so I'm gonna hold that down. I'm gonna tighten that a bit more. You don't need to go crazy, but now we're gonna put since we're there, I just pulled off all the grease of that top part. Okay. Put that on the spring. See how it nests right in that groove, okay? Now this is, kind of need like five hands for this, but got a trick. So actually before I do that, now that that's on, I'd like to get, this is kind of tricky, okay? So this I'd like to do without that getting in the way. So I'm gonna then take this spring, if you remember the spring that went on this part. What you do is you push, you've got the first part of the spring there. You stick that in that direction, and then you push down and you twist. And it kind of twists it right in. There we go. And that's in. Okay? And then you can stick this spring on top. That one stayed, but then the cap. Let's go ahead and actually before we do that, there's a little thing I'd like to do with this cap, and we'll do it on the other end, is there's a little section in here that pops up, and you can see this is kind of like a drag, actually. This is when you tighten that part of the reel. It actually puts pressure on the end of the spool, which holds the spool down. So depending on what kind of fishing you're doing, you know, but I like to clean this out. So you've got one little round piece, and there's actually a divot in there. You can see that divot, okay? So I'm gonna clean this round piece off, okay? I'm gonna clean, this one's like a little more square-ish. Okay, I'm gonna clean that piece off. Okay, there's a little grease on there. I never like grease in there. I just never use it, and I never want it on the back part of there because it gets dirty. And when it gets dirty, the reel's not gonna go very well. All right, so you wanna clean that little cap part out as best as you can. You don't want grease, but I like a little oil. So I put a dot of oil in that little recessed area. I put the round piece in. Okay, and that sits right in that little divot. I put another dot of oil, just really tiny. You really don't want a lot. And then this one goes on top. Okay, and that sits in another recess on the outside, okay? And see how that sits. Well, there's a tiny little recess there, and that'll sit like that. Then I put one more dot, I mean tiny, right in the center, right on top, and you can see just a tiny dot of oil. That's it. And that will go right on top of there. You can see I just lost a... So you want to tighten this down, you don't need it, you want to tighten it right now all the way down. Once you put the spool back on, you want it back up. So I'm going to put this spring back on top, okay? Again, now we're coming to this part where I need like five hands, but, all right, then we put the okay, got to find the groove, there we go. And keep that pushed down like that. On top. And you're pushing down that spring, okay? This is why you need like five hands, okay? So I find that you gotta hold it down. I'm gonna wipe off. I'm actually just gonna use my shirt. The bottom part of the reel handle. You stick that on top, hold it down like that. So now you've got the handle on. Okay. I'm going to re-grease that section again, just the very tip top. Got to wipe some of that off. Okay. I got a little grease in there. sort of. Very top of that. Because we're going to put now this nut on. This nut wasn't greasy at all for some reason, so I don't really need to clean it. It was very, very clean, so I didn't need to clean it. But if you've got a lot of rust on there or something, you're going to want to clean it. So now I got that on there. You want to just tighten it. Don't go crazy, okay? You don't need that super tight. Okay, so you need to basically just tighten that on. You don't need it super tight because we're going to need to adjust it because you see this hole right there. Okay, this you can see has rivets that will sit, depending on how this is angled, might not fit with that hole, which you need to put the screw on, and this needs to fit over top of it. So we're going to put this on. You can see we're actually off center just a little bit, so I need to tighten just a little more. It's just kind of a trial and error, just slightly more. You really don't want this super tight, because if it's super tight, your reel won't reel. There we go. Now, we're going to degrease this. That was the hardest one to get off for some reason. I'm going to degrease that. Alright, so the insides of this is taken care of. Now, that's the gear section. Now we've got to pop this off. And now we're on to a quick cleaning.